Welcome to the second edition of KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm your host, Robert Brock, and in this edition, we have Qt Company and LG Electronics deepen strategic partnership, changes in Qt offerings, Vulkan 1.2 released, what to see at Embedded World 2020, new features and changes in Kuesa 3D Studio, interesting talks at 36th C3 Congress, and some announcements. Lately, the Qt Company and LG Electronics announced that they are going to deepen their strategic partnership. At the core of the collaboration lies LG's WebOS. The agreement represents a joint effort to introduce WebOS to more customers and bring it to more devices. LG developed WebOS using Qt to create the definitive operating system for smart devices. They intend to make WebOS a common platform for multiple different devices and services, not only for themselves, but also for other OEMs and developers all over the world. Through the partnership, the Qt Company will perform continuous integration, which guarantees that WebOS will always be compatible with the latest Qt versions. The Qt Company recently announced some changes in their offerings. First, there will be a low-cost edition of Qt for small companies and startups. Second, the installation of Qt binaries will require a Qt account in the future, also for open source users. Third, long-term supported releases, in short LTS, will be commercial only, starting with the patch releases for Qt 5.15. This news comes out shortly before the filming of this edition, so we didn't have the opportunity to look closer into it. However, we will follow up on it in the next edition. You'll find the link to the announcement in the video description. A new version of the graphics and compute API, Vulkan, has been released. Vulkan 1.2 integrates 23 proven extensions into the core Vulkan API, bringing significant access to new hardware functionality, improved application performance, and enhanced API usability. Many Vulkan 1.2 features were requested by developers to meet critical needs in their engines and applications, including timeline semaphores for easily managed synchronization, a formal memory model to precisely define the semantics of synchronization and memory operations in different threads, descriptor indexing to enable reuse of descriptor layouts by multiple shaders, deeper support for shaders written in HLSL, and more. For further details, check the link below the video. Embedded World, Europe's leading trade fair for embedded technology, will take place from the 25th till 27th of February in Nuremberg, Germany. Those of you working on embedded software projects regularly may have already heard about it. If, however, you're looking for the right software technology for your next embedded project, you might want to learn more about Qt and C++ in the context of embedded devices. You'll find many interesting demos and information about the subject at the Qt partner booth, where KDAB will also be present. Those of you interested especially in IMX8 or IMX8M might like to see a complex 3D demo running on the latter at the KDAB booth, possibly one of the very few using the board at Embedded World. For a first approach to working with Qt and maybe preparing your visit to Embedded World, we provide you with a short introduction to Qt, linked below the video, along with a code for some free tickets. Kuesa 3D Studio, an integrated and unified workflow for 3D designers and developers created by KDAB, was released last year. Recently, KDAB published a new article explaining what Kuesa 3D does, and how it can help you to make your 3D development process much more efficient. The main objective of the latest updates was to ensure compliance with the Kronos GLTF 2.0 specification. In addition, a great deal of work has been put into technical documentation following the Qt standards, which can be found on GitHub. The 1.2 release of Kuesa 3D Studio has been planned for spring of this year. Every year between Christmas and New Year, the Chaos Computer Club organizes the Chaos Communication Congress, offering very interesting lectures, workshops, and various events on a multitude of topics. Many of the talks at the 36th C3 from December 2019 are now available online, going from general views on socio-political aspects to security issues on devices like the iPhones, to how and why the Boeing 737 MAX actually crashed. The list of topics is much longer, so you will probably find something worth watching on a free evening. In our announcements now, Qt World Summit 2020 will soon take place in May, from the 12th till the 14th in Palm Springs, California. As always, before the actual conference, there will be a very well-received training day organized by KDAB, for which the agenda will soon be published. Early bird tickets for Qt World Summit are already available. For our German-speaking viewers who are interested in the use of free software in public administration, there will be an interesting conference on the 4th of May in Berlin, organized by the Free Software Foundation. Links, as always, are in the video description below. Thank you for watching this edition of KDAB News. I hope you liked it, and I look forward to your comments. See you next time.